today we will study about Geiger-Müller counter. It is used to detect number of radiations coming out from a source. It consists of a metal copper cylinder which acts as a cathode, and in it one end is closed by a mica window. It is filled with a inert gas argon plus alcohol vapor of about 10 millimeter of mercury pressure, and a tungsten wire acts as an anode, which is insulated from cathode by an insulating block. The radioactive rays enter from the sample through mica window. Then this anode and cathode are connected by an external circuit through battery to a mechanical resistor, which measures the amount of current produced by the sample. The radioactive substance is placed outside the tube, close to the window. As when a single alpha beta rays enters the tube, it strikes the atoms of the gas argon and causes ionization. These ions migrate to the oppositely charged electrodes and give away their charges. When they give their charges, they become neutral, and in the process a current flows through the external circuit, which is measured by a mechanical resistor. This flow of current is momentous. Then mica end windows are used for detection of weak beta emitters like 14C. Thick end glass window tubes are used for high energy beta emitters like 32P. And windowless flow counters are used to measure beta radiations having very low energy. Geiger counters work in the region where current is totally independent of primary ionizations. Means all the gas atoms that are present in the tube, they become ionized and reach the electrodes, and further increase in potential difference between the two electrodes will not cause an increase in the current produced by the tube. All discharge produced by any type of radiation here are nearly equal in magnitude. It may be alpha, beta or gamma. In Geiger counters, gas amplification is so great that extremely simple external electronic amplifier is sufficient to measure the radioactive event. The disadvantage is it requires a very high voltage of 1500 volts, and this poses a problem. Inability to distinguish pulses. We cannot distinguish between alpha, beta or gamma rays. So this is the disadvantage. It takes some time for the ion pairs to reach the electrodes. During this time, if another radioactive event takes place, it cannot be counted because the gas is already ionized. So this is known as the dead time. This dead time is about 100 to 200 microseconds in case of Geiger-Müller counters, which is too big, and that is why it is a disadvantage, because some radioactive events may not be counted because of dead time. Some ions might escape getting neutralized at the electrodes, so they will recombine, and due to this they produce an ion avalanche. If care is not taken, then Geiger-Müller tube will go into continuous discharge and the instrument will get spoiled. To prevent this, quenchers are used to overcome this problem. Quenchers generally used are alcohol, ethyl formate or halogens. Quenchers, what they do is, for example, when radioactive event takes place, gas, they strike the gas atoms, it gets converted into helium nucleus plus an electron, which start moving towards the electrodes. Some might not be able to reach the electrode, and in the process helium positively charged nucleus will combine with the electron, and in this process they will give off X-rays or UV rays, gamma rays or UV rays. These rays are themselves ionizing, and they will cause further ionization of the gas present in the tube. And due to this, the tube will go in continuous discharge. What happens when we add quenchers like ethanol, butane or ethyl formate? The butanol, when the energy is given off in form of gamma rays or UV rays, they absorb that energy, and in the process the chemical bond between the butane is broken down and further ion pairs are not formed. In this way they stop the Geiger-Müller tube into going into continuous discharge. That is why quenchers are used. The Geiger-Müller tubes are used for many for those experiments in which radioisotopes are used. These radioisotopes, after experimentation, they are separated by chromatographic or electrophoretic methods, and then chromatographic scanners are used to detect these labeled metabolites. These labeled metabolites can be detected by chromatographic scanners based on Geiger-Müller tubes.